nothing changed between us because there was nothing. All that happened was that how should we make them believe the truth, which is such a sad, imagine how sad a state of affairs is for two people who actually adore each other to have to sit back and be like, how do we prove it? So he's like, should I put up these chats? I was like, go for it. Maybe that helps. So he put up chats. Still people were refusing to believe us. Then I gave the girl who has supposedly accused the boy is giving a clarification. Even that doesn't work. He was always present, always giving, always like, you can, you've seen the film, you've seen the trailer. Yeah. You can tell that that's not an actor whose mind is elsewhere. He's all there. His craft, his control over acting, over the technique is so heightened. I still say is because he's just forever, like, it's, I can't say Waltz. It just doesn't come.
It's a mixed feeling for everybody involved with Dil Bechara. They might not have expected such a turnover of events prior to the release, but we have debutante actress Sanjana Sanghi joining us for a conversation only on Pinterest. Welcoming you, Sanjana. How are you?
Thanks, man. I'm okay.
When you remember a person like Sushant so fondly, like if I have to remember him, I would remember him for the conversations that we've had and the intellect that that guy had. There were times that I wouldn't understand half of the things he would say and he would explain it to me. Has that ever happened with you? He was very intelligent.
All the time. I mean, the thing is that like when you're, when you just meet a person, it's very different from when you start, when you know that you have to tell such an intense story together. Then you know that you have to, then you're getting to know that person at an extra level because you and I, even if we were best friends, I wouldn't be that emotionally vulnerable with you as we tend to be as actors with each other because it's our job to feel comfortable to that degree. But also then when you realize that, oh, like she loves studying, she's a nerd, I'm a nerd. She's trained with Ashley all her life. I've trained with Sharmak. She loves food. I love food. We love cinema. It's just like one thing after the other. And then you just become, then you're just like inseparable, right? Like people had to break us up on set. It used to be like, okay, can we now start? Can we get on to work type of thing? Because we would end the scene and then whip out the script and start talking about this book and that book. And it's just, and that was our normal. So I never thought of it as something special or something that's unique. It was just how it was. I didn't have any precedent for it. And so for me, Sushant was the person who understood me at every level and I understood him. So when people say he was an introvert, I don't know because I know he selected his people, but I knew that I was one of them. So I was just like, man, I don't know. But, you know, I know him and I know how he thinks.
I want to know that, you know, when you start off as a debutante, it is very important to have co-actors who will support you and who will take you through that whole process, you know. I remember Sara also saying that how Sushant would always be helping her with a lot of scenes. Did that happen with you? Because he was a very warm person on set. He was very helpful to everybody around.
I didn't realize it till I started filming for Dil Bechara because Dil Bechara is plonked on Kizzy's shoulders. It's a story being told through her eyes. And Sushant had complete humility in knowing that. It was not a surprise. When you read the script, you'll know that this story is this girl's story, how she meets this boy. And then what happens, which is rare because we tend to tell stories from a male gaze in our films up till now. There was complete acceptance of that. And then there was so much humility in his own craft, like his craft, his control over acting, over the technique is so heightened. I still say is because he's just forever, like I can't say Waltz, it just doesn't come. That he gave me my, it's like, you know, one half of a football playing field, that side of the D is yours and this side is mine. And if we need to, we'll keep passing the ball, but otherwise we're dribbling on our own. You know, it was that kind of a thing. And that is everything. And then in an unsaid way, like then he would, it's a very emotional film, very tricky, very heavy. So on one day I would have to cry, we would have to shoot a Taregin, then I would have had to do a scene where I'm falling sick. So it was very, very demanding. And he would, I didn't even have to say it, and he would see me prepping in the corner, send his pot boy, be like, cappuccino de kya? And I, he would just, his boy would come, give it to me. I was like, kya? And he was like, Mani ne bhijwai. And I just got used to these things, because for me, this was our thing. I'm in my van, I'm prepping, he, because he may not have a scene later. So he's like, cricket khelne chale. I'm like, listen, I have to shoot. Just please, like, don't distract me. And then he would be like, bro, like, just play some cricket, just dance. And he would tease me, like, try to distract me. So he really helped make it lighter for me, because I'm that kind of person where I, like, become too, this thing about my work. Like, I'm just like, you know, blinkers on and have to get this done. He sort of lightened it up.
You know, you worked with him on a film, on his last film, for so many months. It has been a labor of love for so many years, actually, of almost 2 years.
Yeah.
Did you ever feel that he had any kind of issues that he was dealing with? Like, nobody knew about it, people are saying that. Did you ever feel it? That there was something that was bothering him?
You know, the thing is that if you know... I met Sushant on Dil Bechara, right? I didn't know him in 2016. I didn't know him before Dil Bechara. So for me, the only Sushant I knew was the Sushant I met. So whether he was quiet, whether he was jovial, whether he was focused, whether he was not, for me, that was the parameter. So I never, my mind also didn't go on ke, it was because also he was always present, always giving, always, like, you can, you've seen the film, you've seen the trailer, you can tell that that's not an actor whose mind is elsewhere. He's all there. So for me, I saw a person, an artist who's as passionate as can be and totally committed to the job and also supportive and also collaborative. So where was, there was no scope for me to even think anything else, honestly.
Today in the morning, there has been a report which says, you know, the psychiatrist has given a statement, somebody, some tabloid has reported that he was undergoing, he was going through bipolar disorder. He was diagnosed with it. So, but my...
I haven't read that report. Yeah.
Yeah, but my question is that, you know, you being a co-actor, did you ever face it? You never did. Yes.
I mean, see, I'm not a psychologist. I wish I was, to be an authority, to be like, this person has bipolar or mild depression. I've had my best friends who I've grown up with, who today we're 23. It's the pandemic. Everyone's losing jobs. It's a tough time.
Yeah.
And I, and they come and tell me that, listen, we're going to therapy. And I'm like, that's awesome. Like, I look at therapy, I look at mental health in a very different perspective, because I studied psychology in school. I loved the subject. And I feel that we all should be aware of our mental health.
Yeah.
But I don't, even with my childhood best friends, I've never been able to be like, oh, I think she's going through a depression, so to say. We always... I can be like, I know it's a tough time, but that circumstantial, like, I'm going through a tough time right now.
Yeah.
It's not, this is not easy for me right now. So, yeah. So, I don't know about the illness part of it, because that's not how your mind works, you know, when you're with a person, when you're... and if he would have ever let something off to me or told me, then I would have had that conversation.
Yeah.
But he never did.
And then I read a post a few weeks later, after you were... called by the police, you wrote that you, this might be your last visit, and a lot of speculations were that you don't want to do films anymore. Did that affect you so much?
No, because it's misconstrued. I'm from Delhi. I've been in Delhi since the beginning of lockdown, since March. I flew to Bombay for a day. And
yeah.
When I flew to Bombay after the pandemic, the streets were abnormally quiet. There was stunned silence. I've never experienced Bombay like that. And sunsan is the only word that came to my mouth. And the honest truth is, Nen, that like, I am, this is me, right? Like, I'm not giving you off any less than who I am right now. This is what I am in totality. And I want to say what's on my mind. And that made me realize, it came onto the headlines and mom woke me up. She slapped me with the newspaper on my bum and she was like, what is this? And I was like, what? She's like, they're saying you're bidding adieu to Bombay and Bollywood. And she's like, she tried to tell me that, Sanj, people aren't here to understand you for you. They will make other meanings out of what you say. So please watch what you say. And I fought with her because I was like, Mom, I haven't said anything wrong. They understood me incorrectly. I'm happy to clarify. But I don't want to stop speaking what comes to my heart, you know. it was misunderstood. I flew in and I flew out because it's a pandemic. We aren't shooting in Bombay. I'll go to Bombay, I'll go to Manali, I'll go to LA, I'll go wherever work takes me when work restarts. So sadly or not, I'm here to stay. I'm here to tell too many more stories because I love acting way too much.
But before we go and round up, you know, there is this conversation that I really want to have with you because it involves you. When that whole Me Too thing happened, the people who got the most affected were you, Sushant, and of course, when something like that happens, you know, there is a discussion about how the relationships on set also can get affected. How did you guys deal with that situation? Sushant was definitely bothered by all the news and it was out there. Did you speak up with him? What was the conversations that you had at that point?
So there were two things. One is that everyone thinks that only Sushant was the one troubled there. I was as troubled because when that's nothing happens. Yeah, I'm just saying that you said it now, but usually that's not how people see it. So the thing is that you know your truth, right? We knew our truth. We were there. I know what he means to me. He knows what I mean to him. And that's all that's important, first of all. And we were on set shooting every day. So when one or two articles come, you can't pay heed to every rumor that comes out. So you just let it go. But then yeah. when it became rampant, I'm a graduate from Delhi University in journalism and I'm a gold medalist. And I've interned at the best of media houses to learn that journalism is one of accuracy and honesty and integrity. And so when I see articles which are baseless, I have no respect for them. Neither do I have respect for the people who write them. Neither do I have respect for the people who believe them. So I have been grown up, like my parents have brought me up in a way that they told me that you know your truth. And now and then, like, people, when they see our film, when they get to know me, when they want to know Sushant for who he was, they'll know our truth. Nothing changed between us because there was nothing. All that happened was that how should we make them believe the truth, which is such a sad, imagine how sad a state of affairs is for two people who actually adore each other to have to sit back and be like, how do we prove it? So he's like, should I put up these chats? I was like, go for it, maybe that helps. So he put up chats, still people were refusing to believe us. Then I gave the girl who has supposedly accused the boy is giving a clarification. Even that doesn't work. And that made me sit back and be like, what kind of a society are we in? Are we just waiting to want to believe a certain reality because we like it when there are problems and negativity? Can't people just accept that we really like each other, we're really working well and we're making a beautiful film? What's the problem? I couldn't understand. I was too young and too inexperienced also. So yeah. I didn't know how to, you know, cope with it.
No, I was saying that when that thing came out in the first place, what was Sushant's reaction? What did you guys talk about? And somehow, you know, I'm asking you this because I know you have been asked this a lot many times. So it's maybe time that you clarify it. That somehow a lot of people say that, why did you take that, you know, 2-3 weeks or 4 weeks to come out with your side of the story? Do these kind of things that you're asked all the time bother you even now? Because, you know, the situation is so terrible.
They hurt me because they've troubled me in the past and it reminds me of a time that made me very uncomfortable. And they see it as time, but the truth is they don't know our reality. If they are waiting for lies to be clarified, I don't want to perpetuate that culture. I don't want to be in a place where every rumor that's written about me, I have to come out with my trusted colleagues to clarify them time and again. So I didn't take time is the truth. And there was nothing that I shouldn't have needed to clarify anything in the first place is the point. Because nothing happened. He was the greatest co-star I could have had. And I have every ounce of love and respect for him as he did for me. If yeah. something actually happened, we wouldn't have gone ahead, done our Paris schedule, finished our film, dubbed our film. It would have not been like this. So, you know, I just would really urge people to believe only the truth. It's sad that the truth is not fed to them, though, and that's not their fault.
Thank you so much. Actually, this, you know, this has been a wonderful conversation. I know it's been a difficult road for you in the last 1.5 months, so to say. It's been a difficult journey for everybody involved on that film, everybody who loves Sushant. But I have said this to the in the interview with Mukesh, and I will say that and I'll reiterate that this movie is not just a movie anymore. It's become a universal emotion that people are willing to watch and embrace. So all the best, more power to you. And just for our love for Sushant and his legacy, I hope that this film works really, really well.
I hope so too. I hope so too. Thank you.